Hello students of class 8. So today I'm going to discuss the next exercise, that is exercise 6.7. So see students, already in the last lecture I have discussed the identities. Okay, so I have discussed the two identities. So I have derived the formula. Okay, and there are many identities. So you have to remember all the identities to do the questions. Okay, so see in 6.7 and in 6.8 you have to do the questions using identities. Okay, so let us start. See in question number 1, which identity we have to use. So the identity used here, we are using identity x plus a into x plus b, and the formula for this one is x square plus bracket a plus b into x plus ab. Okay, so already it is given in the question that you have to use this formula. So see, let us do the first one. So in first bracket x plus c, and in second bracket is x plus d. So both are what? Multiplied with each other. So what we can write? We can write x square plus, inside bracket we can write a plus b into x plus ab. That means in place of a and b we can write c plus d. So similarly here c and d will be multiplied. So finally we can write x square plus c into x will be cx plus d into x will be dx. So here we are applying the distributive property. Okay, so come to the next one, number 2. So here it is written p plus a into p plus b. So in place of x, what is written? P. So using this formula, we can write, here it is x square, you can compare and you can simply write. So this will be p square plus, inside bracket we can write a plus b into p plus ab, which is equal to p square plus a into p will be ap plus b into p will be bp plus ab. Okay. Next is question number 5. So x plus 7 into x minus 5. So see, it will be x square plus, inside the bracket the formula was a plus b. So here the value of b is what? 5, but before 5 we have minus sign. So we have to write what? We can write like this, see, a plus b. But a is positive, it's okay, 7. But b is what? It is a negative value. So in place of b we have to write minus 5. So a plus b will be what? 7 plus minus 5. So plus minus will be what? Minus. Okay, so 7 minus 5. So 7 minus 5 into x plus, the formula was a into b, okay, in the last term. So a will be 7 and b will be what? Minus 5. So here you can see 7 minus 5 will be 2. So 2x minus 7 into 5 will be 35, and minus sign is there. So you have to write minus sign. Okay. Next come to the 7 number. 7 number is also same, but both the number are in minus. So again see, x square will be there next. Inside the bracket we have to write minus 8 minus 2 into x plus, then we have to multiply the value of a with b. So here a is minus 8 and b is minus 2. Okay, so minus 8 into minus 2 will be plus 16. So x square, this will be minus 10x plus 16. Okay. So let us do the next question, that is question number 2. In question number 2, we have to use this identity a plus b square. Okay, so what is the value of a plus b square? Yes, it is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Okay, so using this identity we can find many values. See, if there is a question, suppose in question they are asking that find the value of 1009 whole square. So in place of 1009 we can write 1000 plus 9 whole square. Okay, I can split 1009 into two parts. Okay, so after splitting I got 1000 and the second part is 9. So 1000 plus 9 will be what? It will be same, this identity a plus b whole square. Okay, so this will be what? 1000 plus 9 whole square. So we can use this formula here also. So see the next question under this, number 2. p plus q whole square. So what will be the answer? Yes, p square plus twice ab, in place of a we have p, in place of b we have q, plus q square. So p square plus 2 into p into q will be 2pq plus q square. Okay, so next is number third, x plus 3 whole square. So see, x square plus 2, in place of a we have x, and in place of b we have 3. Okay, so here also a square, a means x, plus twice ab, a is x, b is what, 3 here, so twice ab, plus b square, so in place of b we have 3. Okay, so see, x square plus 2 into x into 3 will be what, 2 3s are 6, so 6 into x, plus 3 square, 3 square will be 9. Okay, so see the next one, number 8. So this is 3x by 4 plus 1 whole square. So here in place of a, what is written? 3x by 4. So the value of a is 3x by 4 and the value of b is 1. So we can write a square, that is 3x by 4 whole square, plus twice ab. So in place of a, we can write 3x by 4, and in place of b, we can write 1. And plus b square. B square will be what? 1 square. So see, here we have to square the first term. So 3 square will be 9. Okay, next x square. So x square. Next, in denominator we have 4. So 4 square will be 16. Okay. Now see here, we have to multiply the numerator. So 2 3s are 6. 6 into 1. So that will be 6. And our variable is only x. So we have to write x along with this. And denominator is 4. Okay. Plus 1 square will be 1. So finally, after cancelling this, we can write 9x square by 16 plus 3x by 2 plus 1. Okay. A square. A is 2x square y whole square. Okay. Plus twice ab. So in place of a, 2x square y, and in place of b, we have 3xy square. Plus b square. B is 3xy square. So square of this. Okay. So see how to do square, because here are in first term we have three numbers, you can say. One is 2, the second is x square and y, both all are multiplied with each other. So first of all we will square the constant term. So 2 square, next will be x square square. Okay, next will be y square, and next see twice ab term will be, first of all multiply the constant. So 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. Okay, next x square into x, next y into y square. Okay, next see 3 square, x square, y square square. Okay, so see what will be the final answer. 2 square will be 4, x square square, you have to apply the law of exponents. So 2 into 2 will be 4, next y square, plus 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, x square into x will be x cube. Again we are applying the law of exponent here. This will be, so this will be x to the power 4, then y square, plus this will be 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. Okay, x square into x will be x cube, and y into y square will be y cube. Here also we are applying the laws of exponent, base is same, so we can add the power. Okay, so 2 plus 1 is 3. Similarly here also the power of y will be 3. Next is the last term, that is 3 square. 3 square will be 9. 9x square, this will be x square, and this will be y to the power 4. Okay, so come to the next question, question number 3. Okay, so see, which identity we are using? A minus b whole square, which is equal to a square minus twice ab plus b square. So see the first one, x minus b whole square. Okay, so in place of a we have x, so we will apply the formula, x square minus twice ab, in place of a we have x, in place of b we have b, so b. Okay, plus b square, so the b in place of b we have b, so x square minus 2xb plus b square. Okay, next come to the next one, number 7, 3x square minus 2y square whole square. So again see, in place of a we have 3x square, in place of b we have 2y square. So formula, according to the formula we have first a square, so a is 3x square, so in place of a we have to write 3x square whole square, minus twice AB. So 2A is 3x square, B is 2y square. Okay. Next, plus B square. So what is the value of B? 2y square. So in place of B, we have to write 2y square. This will be whole square. Okay. Next, 3 square will be 9 and x square, I have written here directly, x square will be x to the power 4, because here we are applying the same law, laws of exponents. So square will be what? 2, under 2 will be 4. Next, 2, 3 is 6, 6 to the 12, okay. Next, x square, y square. Then next, 2 square will be 4 and y square will be y to the power 4, okay. So next, number 8, 47 square, see, we can write 47 as 40 plus 7. But according to this question, we have to apply a minus b whole square identity. So we have to take the, we have to split 47 so that there will be a minus symbol between the two numbers. Okay. So I am splitting like this. See, 50 minus 3. So in place of 47, I am writing 50 minus 3. So 50 minus 3 whole square. So what is the value of AC here? The value of A is 50 and the value of B is 3. So this will be 50 square, because A square, okay, A square minus twice AB, okay, twice AB. So 2 in place of A will be 50, B will be 3 plus B square, okay, B is 3, so 3 square. So 50 square will be 2500, okay. Then 2 5s are 10, 10 3s are 30. And after that we have to write 10, so that means finally we got what? 300 by multiplying all these numbers. Next, 3 square will be 9. So first of all we have to add 2509, we will get 2509, then we have to subtract 300 from it, so finally we will got this. Okay, so no doubt you can multiply 47 two times and you can finally find the answer. Okay, by that way you can check this answer is correct or not. But here we need to use this identity to find the value of 47 square. So if it is given that you have to use identity, that means what? You have to use the identity. Okay. Next, come to question number 9, 59 square. Again, for applying the identity of a minus b whole square, so I have to split 59 like 60 minus 1, okay, so that I can easily apply this formula a minus b whole square. So in place of a, what is the value of a here? 60 and b is 1. So formula was a square, so 60 square, okay, first of all, minus twice a is 60 and what is in b is 1, okay, plus b square, b is what? 1 square, okay. So in place of A, we are writing what? 60 square. So like this, we are applying. So the formula was A square minus 2AB plus B square. So 60 square will be 3600, that means 3600. Then this will be 120 and 1 square will be 1. So 3601 minus 120. You can subtract and find the answer easily. Next, see question number 4. So here we are using this identity A plus B into A minus B. That is a square minus b square. Okay, so see the first the question number 2 here. In place of a we have a, but in place of b we are having 3. Okay, so we can write this as a square minus b square. So in place of b we have 3 square, so we'll write b as 3, so 3 square. So a square minus 9. Similarly, see the next one, number 4. In place of a we have 3x and in place of b we have 4y. So again, a square minus 4y. You can see here, a minus b into a plus b. The same number is repeating again. Here this is in minus, here this is in plus. Okay. So the formula is 9x square, 3 square will be 9, and x square will be x whole square will be x square, 4 square will be 16, and y square will be y square. Okay. Next, number 6 again, see. Here the value of a is 5xy and the value of b is 7. So a square means 5xy whole square minus b square means 7 square. So 5xy square will be 25x square y square minus 7 square will be 49. Next, see number 7. So here the value of a is x square and the value of b is y square. Okay. So first of all, a square will be x square, because in place of a we have x square. and in place of b we are having y square. Okay, so x square square will be what? X to the power 4, because power gets multiplied using the law of exponent. Similarly here also 2 into 2 will be 4. So finally we got x to the power 4 minus y to the power 4. Next, see, there is a question 105 into 95. So in what we can put in place of 105 into means how we can split 105 and 95 so that it will so that we can apply this identity. Okay, so how to write? See, I'm writing in place of 105 as 100 plus 5 and 95 as 100 minus 5. So see, the value of a is 100, so 100 square according to this identity, minus b will be what? 5, so 5 square. So 100 square will be what? 10,000 minus 5 square will be 25. So finally you can solve this answer, you will get 9975 as the final answer. Okay, next see students, this question is similar what we have done in question number 1. Okay, the same question. So here all the question are in numbers, given in numbers. So see, first question is 12 into 18. So 12 into 18 I can split and I can write it as 10 plus 2. 10 plus 2 will be 12. See, and in place of 18 I can write 10 plus 8. Like this also we can write, and see, I can write like this also. 20 minus 8 will be 12 and 20 minus 2 will be what? 18. Okay, so I am doing in both the ways. See, what will be the final answer? Again we have to apply the same identity here. Just here the value of a and b are positive, but here the value of a and b are negative. There it is the only difference in this in the two process. Okay, so you can see here 10 square. So see student, 10 square will be 100, then 10 inside the bracket we have 2 plus 8, so we can write 10, and 2 8 0 will be 16, so 116. Okay, so next see here, by using this one also we are getting the same answer. This will be 20 square will be 400, 20 into minus 10 inside the bracket plus minus 8 into minus 2 will be 16. So 400 plus 16, 416 minus 200 will be 216. Similarly you have to do the remaining question. See here, in this particular question number 2, I am writing it as 100 plus 4. I am splitting the two numbers, so 100 plus 3. Okay, rest of the things you have to do by yourself. Here also you can write 100 minus 5 in place of 95, and 102 will be 100 plus 2. So rest you have to do it by yourself. Okay, next. See, in place of 198, 200 minus 2 will be 198. Okay, next 209 will be 200 plus 9. So what is the thing you have to keep in mind is, first number inside the bracket, inside both the brackets should be same, so that you can apply this identity. What was the identity? X plus A into X plus B is equal to this one. So in this, see, the first term inside the bracket, inside the two brackets are same. Okay, so please try to do these questions. Okay, and if you face any difficulty you can ask me. Okay, thank you students.